out today at SeaWorld, and we are going to check out all their safety precautions that they have in store for families to keep you safe. We're getting ready to enter the tent to get our temperature taken, and then we're going to go through the front gates, so come along with us. They don't use a thermometer to check your forehead. They use a camera to check your temperature. So we were waiting for the thermometers to get the temperature, and they never came up and put it on our forehead. You just walk right through, and they can read your temperature. Pretty cool. Next up, we're going through security. So we're going to go and make sure we don't have anything dangerous in our backpacks. And then we're going to go into the park with our reservation. All right, we made it through security. They use a stick to go through your bag. They don't actually reach in or grab or touch anything in your bag, so that's good. And now we're gonna go through the front entrance, see what that looks like. Okay, we're through the entrance. You hold your phone or your ticket up to a plexiglass. They scan it through the plexiglass, no touch. Very well done. As you can see behind me, lots of hand sanitizing stations. We like that too. Let's go see what else they've got for us. So they also have lines showing you where you can and can't stand, which is a great idea. One that works well. We haven't seen them wiping down the cars. It's not to say that they're not wiping them down, but two or three cars have gone by and we haven't seen it yet. So not sure how often they're wiping them. But they do have hand sanitizer at the start and at the end of the ride, so maybe that helps. We brought our own hand sanitizer just to be safe, and we brought our own gloves for rides. The dolphin pool, but unfortunately not a lot of social distancing going on here, so we're just gonna look at them from afar. We found a hole in the fence and we have some social distancing, so we're getting up close to check out the dolphins. We're not doing too many rides today. We're mostly just checking out the animals, staying outside. So we're gonna go check out Pacific Point Reserve. See what they got going on.
That's a big feather right there.
as you can see, some additional not social distancing. When one of the sea lions jumped up, everybody congregated, so I know that's difficult to protect from, but you just gotta make sure you're paying attention to you and your family and stay separate from everybody. One of the things that I do like is that they have one way around Pacific Point Reserve, so you can see the arrows telling you what direction to go in. For the Taste of the Seven Seas, the food festival that they normally do here at SeaWorld has been drastically cut back. They have one cart that's located across from Mako, and they rotate every weekend some of the different flavors from their Seven Seas food festival. So today we're doing the North Atlantic variety of food, and we're just doing a little taste test of it, and the sun is slowly going down. So as the sun slowly goes down, the Electric Ocean Remix is gonna kick on, and we cannot wait to see what that's all about. So we'll see in a little bit. Let's go check out and see how the kids are doing in Sesame Street. Okay, we just finished our day at SeaWorld. We walked around the park. The kids did the Mako ride and they did the Manta ride. I insisted they sit in the front row. They wore gloves, they wore their masks. We sanitized down after the ride. The only reason I was okay with it is because they were roller coasters, they were outside, and they sat in the front row. So that helped me let them do it. The table where we sat and ate wasn't clean, but we brought our own wipes and were able to wipe it down. We found one hand sanitizer bottle that was out, but then we had another one that had some there, and of course we brought our own too. We saw a lot more people not wearing their masks properly. I am sort of behind a plant here where I'm hiding, but we actually saw a lot more people without masks than I probably would have liked. Maybe they were below their nose or down as chin guards, or they just weren't wearing them at all. We did have two employees that we saw that told people to put masks on, and unfortunately some people put them on and pulled them right back down. But you know, that's always going to be a challenge when you're out at parks like this. So we just make sure that we stay really far away and don't get too close to them. We went through the Sesame Street area, which was pretty empty, but the splash pad inside Sesame Street was kicking. A lot of kids on the rides. That was one other thing that struck me probably, is that the rides were pretty packed. When we went to Disney, they were sitting in like every other row. Here, they were pretty much sitting every row. But they didn't put parties together. So my son went on Mako by himself and they put him in a row all by himself. So a little different there that they're doing. And overall, it was a nice night. We came, we walked around, we got some food. They're doing the Electric Ocean Remix where they're playing music. They've got the fireworks going on at 9, but we're pretty beat because, of course, walking around with your mask in this heat takes a lot out of you. So we're going to cut out a little early before the fireworks. But all in all, it was a nice night out. Once the sun started going down, the breeze kicked in and it was a nice evening. So, you know, we'll probably be back and do it all over again. Again, part of the challenge with COVID is you just have to take all the responsibility and make sure that you're the one staying away from those that aren't doing what they're supposed to be doing. And using good judgment, if something makes you uncomfortable, don't do it. So it's just that simple. But we will see you next time. For now, thanks SeaWorld for a nice night out away from the house, and we'll catch you guys later.